Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. It's been quite a while since I saw you. I hope I'll see you more often going forward. And thank you so much for all your love and support, and I hope I'll keep getting that going forward as well. So with respect to today's video, I'm going to talk about the most prominent jobs that are available in the data science space and also how you can crack these jobs. Okay. I primarily want to divide this entire data science industry into two parts at a very high level. Number one, jobs that require extensive programming abilities. And number two, jobs that don't require programming abilities but still help you be in that decision-making scenarios. So let's get started with a simple data set. And this data set is representative of a food delivery client. Okay, this is all sample and only for educational purposes. Now let's take for example, Swiggy has delivered to a person named Hassan, okay, a food order, and that particular individual has spent $75 on the delivery fee, okay. The delivery time predicted was 20 minutes and it took 20 minutes, so the delay is zero, right? And the area in which this individual was delivered, let's say A, okay. Now if I take this as a typical record of any individual on the Zomato or Swiggy database, let's see what it would look like if we had 10 more records, right? If we had 10 more records, let's say Pratik, Pirates, Gladiators, different names, right? And these are the spent in terms of rupees on each delivery order. And we say here, column J, what was the typical delay for each one of these orders? For Pratik, it was 3 minutes of delay time, and for one of the orders there was a 13 minute delay, right? What does that indicate? There are a lot of delays and probably Swiggy or Zomato should do something about these delays, right? Now what are the jobs available with this, right? Now we have only 10 sample data set. Now imagine there are millions of customers, millions of data sets in this particular scenario. So the first job that we are going to talk about is the ETL, that is Extraction, Transformation and Loading Analyst. Now what is this job? Payment information is coming from the payment gateway, and the delivery information is coming from the delivery executive, and then probably some other information is coming from some other systems. So for all these systems, the data is brought together and presented in either an Excel in front of us or in some Teradata format. So that is extraction, transformation, loading from different databases, different systems, so that it's easily manageable for somebody who is trying to make sense of the data. That's number one. Now the second category, which does not require a lot of programming knowledge as such, is your data analyst or business analyst kind of roles, right? Now what does a data analyst or a business analyst do? They take this data, probably millions of rows, if they know Python, if they know SAS, if they know R, SPSS, they start making some small data analysis and try to make sense of the data. Okay, what is the average delay time? So on and so forth, right? Then they put it in nice visualization dashboards and they present it to the executives, right? Or to their senior management. That you do not need hardcore programming language. If you know a visualization tool and if you know, let's say Python, you can basically get that job with 1 to 3 years experience in any industry, right? So that is not a hardcore programming job, right? Number three, again, we'll move back into the programming side, is your algorithm developers, right? Algorithm developers are basically predicting, hey, what is the potential for a delay on a particular order for tomorrow, right? These guys are developing predictive models continuously, right? And that predictive model development needs a certain set of statistical skills, programming skills, and you can get these through probably doing a master's in data science, right? Honestly, this is a rare skill in the market. So if you want to get into this space in the data science industry, there's a lot of money. People would love to pay and have you on their teams, right? That's number three, hardcore programming. Now, on the other side is again your business decision makers, right? So, somebody who can understand this entire data and present it to a client or present it to a senior management. They can manage a set of people. They can manage a team of data scientists. What do they know? They have a basic understanding of how to do data analysis. They have a basic understanding of the tool, and they can make sense of the data in such a way that they can guide a team of data scientists or guide a team of analysts to get the results that he or she is looking for. And these guys then go and present it for the executives or the senior management. Now, what is the skill required here? The basic skill required is your domain knowledge. If you have domain knowledge, if you have good understanding of the food delivery industry, and if you are proficient enough, or if you are at least okay, and if you can understand Python, if you have a fair enough idea about algorithms, then that job is for you, right? So you can see that there are four kinds of specific jobs that we have talked about. Very clearly, two are in the decision making space, where you do not need to have hardcore programming skills, and there are two jobs where you probably need hardcore programming skills to actually move forward in your data science career, right? Now, going forward, if you want to move into the data science space, just get started with the understanding of Python or understanding of what basic statistics mean, mean, median, mode, so on and so forth, and then subsequently start understanding how can you represent this information to an executive, right? And that will help you get started with this entire career path. If you are interested to learn more about these things, please check a link in the description box, and we'll be happy to assist you going forward on that. Thank you so much for watching the video, guys, and we look forward to seeing you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.